Hello, welcome back to switch my fan on. Welcome back to Batman. Batman the Telltale series. I've been looking forward to this for a little while. I didn't actually get the Batman Telltale series for a little while. My other half got it for me about a week ago. So I haven't had that long to wait for this one, but I'm sort of dreading finishing this because then I've got to wait a long time for the next episode, and I've never actually done this before with a Telltale game. I've never actually been one of the ones who has to sit there and wait for the next episode. It's always just been on. So I've always bought them in bulk. I've always been the kind of guy who I'm really impatient. I cannot stand waiting for things. I'm just not a patient guy. I cannot stand waiting for things. Cannot stand having to sit here and realize I can't play it anymore. If I get a box set or something, I need to buy the box set and have it all there for me to watch all the way through and binge on it. This kind of looks like Liverpool, actually. Weirdly enough. But yeah, let's begin. Hope everybody had a good day today. Mine was okay. Children of Gotham. Children of Arkham, sorry. I'm going to change the Steam title because that's not what I put on the stream title. Children of Arkham. That's a lot more poetic than Children of Gotham. Children of Gotham seems a bit... I don't know. Children of... Arkham. There we go. So, thank you for being with me in this one, folks. Let's start the episode. Let's get going. An old friend welcomes a new adversary as Bruce learns more about the Wayne family legacy and Batman escalates the fight against crime and corruption throughout Gotham. Hooray!
A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door! When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Together, we will change Gotham. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Your father knew which hands to shake.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal?
It's dangerous.
Bye, Bat.
This is Selina.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces. Falcone's calling card.
The chemicals. Where are they?
We're all being played here, including you.
Stick around.
It's... the Waynes. Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
Well, see how that pans out. Adapt. Tailored.
Mr.
Don't forget to say hi if you're in the chat.
You don't have to do this.
Only you now, Master Bruce.
Crime Alley. Okay.
I thought I might find you here. The news was upsetting for both of us.
But you should see this.
I know you come here for solitude, Bruce.
More allegations about his ties to the underworld.
This isn't going away.
It's all so public and messy.
People are throwing stones at my family, Alfred. I need to understand why.
It's my family, too. Don't forget that. I've been dreading this day for nearly two decades. I hoped it would never come.
Forget the papers. I want to hear it from you.
The truth is, they were billionaires, Bruce. You can't amass that kind of wealth without making certain moral compromises. It's just not possible. That kind of money taints you.
You kept their secrets for them.
I'm trying to help you understand.
Then try harder!
Hill greased the wheels of politics. Falcone was the muscle. Thomas legitimized the whole enterprise with his name. Your father, Hamilton Hill, and Falcone, they were partners. Nothing happened in Gotham without them knowing.
Falcone, the papers, they were telling the truth. Everyone knew about this but me.
I know it's a lot to take in. I want you to know, I had my suitcases ready. I couldn't stand to be around your father anymore. But then, they were killed. And you were all alone. And I just couldn't walk out the door. Everything I did, everything I've ever done, was out of love for you. I hope you can forgive me.
How could I hold this against you? You're all I've got, Alfred.
Thank you. I won't let you down again. This is the first time I've been back here since that night. When the police called me to collect you, I thought they'd finally arrested your father. I couldn't believe a low-life thug like Joe Chill would have the audacity to rob and kill Thomas Wayne. He was simply too well known. Too big. Yet, there it was.
He got careless. Criminals always do.
You always said it was a simple mugging. In 20 years, you've never wavered from that story.
I can recall every moment of that night in vivid detail. But maybe that's wrong.
Sometimes we block out things we don't want to face.
Maybe there was some detail I overlooked.
Oh, okay. This is the first part where we actually get to do stuff. Why were they walking through this alley? That's what I want to know. Oh, there's going to be a debate. Mayoral debate. Sorry if I'm coughing, folks. So I'll get you over that.
I want him standing here. Right now.
And what would the Batman do with his own parents' killer? The possibilities are frightening.
I wouldn't trust myself around him.
Batman doesn't kill.
Yeah,
that's why I wouldn't trust myself.
He was stabbed to death in prison. No one mourns for Joe Chill, Bruce.
Again, why are they walking down
the... He just wanted to protect us.
He thought he was invincible. Sadly, he was mistaken.
I always wanted to be brave. Just like him.
And you are. He would be so proud to see that you took a different path.
I love that movie. Saw it countless times at that theater. How long did it play there?
Only when you wanted to see it, Bruce. Your mother arranged the special screenings personally.
I never knew that. She was always so good to me.
Where exactly does the memory end?
With my father pleading, you don't have to do this. And the gun fires.
And after that? There are considerable gaps in that recollection.
Maybe. Do I really want to know?
Bruce, are you all right?
It wasn't a mugging. They were assassinated. And Carmine Falcone knows why.
Well, at least we stabbed him in the last episode. I'd have been really fucking annoyed if I hadn't. But it ends up that the other partner in that threesome killed the parents, not Falcone. I bet you Falcone and Thomas Wayne were like really good friends. But fell out or something. So Thomas Wayne thinks that Falcone killed him when it actually wasn't.
Getting you in to see Falcone like this? I don't have to tell you how many rules we're breaking. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm always here for you, but this could land us both in hot water. I pulled all the strings I had with the lieutenant. This better not come back to bite us.
Relax, Harv. No one needs to know. We'll be out of here in no time.
Oh, relax, he says. As if Bruce Wayne won't turn every head in the building. The last time we brushed shoulders with Falcone, the press made us pay. At least tell me what this is about. Look, I'm all for blind support, but I should at least know what I'm getting myself into.
This is a personal matter, Harvey.
Fine, fine, don't tell me. But I hope none of this comes back to bite us. I don't want headlines taking away from my debate with Hill.
Dent, Mr. Wayne, welcome to the GCPD.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Now, ordinarily, we'd never let you in to see Falcone, but it must be nice to have a DA in your pocket, Mr. Wayne. Bend the rules whenever you need it.
Harvey's not in my pocket, Lieutenant. He always does what he thinks is right.
Well, it's lucky your interests align.
Fuck you, Gordon.
Nice job bringing in Falcone.
Yeah, that son of a bitch better not get off again.
He's not getting off the hook, Renee. Not this time.
Mr. Wayne, Sergeant Renee Montoya.
I just wanted to say, you know, some of us police support you, despite what the media is saying.
Thanks, Sergeant.
We had to put Falcone in the infirmary. Batman practically tore him in half. He's helped us a lot in the past, but if you ask me, he's out of control.
Well, if it makes the city safer, who cares if a few thugs get hurt?
I care. That's not the city I want to live in.
Well, at least someone's getting tough on these guys. I tell you, I'd rather have Falcone in here than out on the street.
You weren't there, Harvey. You didn't see it. All right, Falcone's inside. Say what you gotta say. We'll be out here.
All right. Ha. That's what you get.
Bruce Wayne, you must have some clout. My own wife can't get in to see me. Good thing I'll be out of here in a week. It's like a mausoleum in here.
You look like you tangled with the wrong guy.
Goddamn Batman. I haven't took a beating this bad since before I got made. Your father used to sew me up. Better than these cop doctors. Yeah, that's right. Tommy and I were close. More than friends. More like cousins. Going back decades.
Until you sent Joe Chill to kill him.
Ah, so that's what this is really about, eh? The pup digging up a 20-year-old killer.
Two killings. And they were never forgotten.
You and me, we're practically family. I thought you'd have figured that out by now. I tried to get through to you at Dent's party. You showed me the door. Got a whole closet full of birthday presents I was never able to give you.
Convince me then. Tell me a story about our big, happy family.
There it is. Now I got you hooked. Your father. Hill and me, we ran this city. Still do. God damn this pain. Can't think through it. Morphine's on the side there. Be a good boy and help Uncle Carmine out, huh?
Can I kill him with this? I'm not gonna hurt him. I mean,
40 years I keep my veins clean of any of that gunk. But you never forget the tender kiss. It'd be so easy to give me the whole vial, wouldn't it? Enough there to put an old dog down forever. Of course, you'd never know the whole story. How much of your parents do you have in you? What kind of son did Thomas Wayne make?
I need you coherent, or you would be gone already.
Oh, there it is. That Wayne streak. Much better, kid. Thank you. Just you like that reminds me of your mother. Your father may have been the doctor, but Martha, she had the human touch. I think you got more of her in you, tell the truth.
I lost her so young. I hardly remember anything about her.
She had steel in her, did Martha. She was the only one that ever had a hold on your father.
until you hired an assassin to kill them both.
What, you really think I hired Chill? Sure. I worked with Joe Chill from time to time. Put a button on someone, he'd take him out. But I never ordered that hit on your parents.
So who did?
You can't trust anyone in Gotham. Least of all those you call friend. Your parents learned that.
Oh, shit.
They're waiting for you in hell!
Montoya! Put the weapon down!
The bastard had to die.
Hands in the air! Stand down! Get a doctor! Secure this floor! No one gets in or out! Go!
Oh.
Go!
Shit. I bought us some time, but not much. Word's gonna get out, sooner or later. Why would she do something like this? We had Gotham's biggest crime lord in our grasp. This close, we were this close.
I don't know. I hardly recognized her when she burst in. She was so different from the woman we met in the hall.
It's a disgrace. Another officer gone rogue.
Just doesn't make any sense. She'd never do anything to hurt the department.
Falcone's case meant justice for 1,000 unnamed victims. And now it is a PR disaster. How can I run against corruption when our own cops are redecorating the precinct with their prisoners' brains? Listen, we gotta get out in front of this. We gotta spin it as best we can. Issue a statement saying that we have the shooter in custody. Details are still coming in and that we're investigating. The usual.
Someone planned this for a reason.
Even if that's true, the simple fact is she gunned him down in his hospital bed.
Lieutenant, Mr. District Attorney, Falcone's lawyers are here.
Oh, Christ. I can delay them for a little while, but we still need answers.
Tell me if she says anything. I have to know why she did this.
Alfred, Falcone's been murdered.
Good God.
I'm looking into it, but I'll need access to the back computer for...
Thing is, right? I really hurt him, that's why he's in hospital, and that's why he was shot in hospital. So if I didn't hurt him in the first episode, would he still be alive? That would be amazing if so. That's really cool if so.
Anything I find.
Connection secured.
Alfred, I'm gonna try and confirm some suspicions of mine. Her veins. Still visible beneath her skin. Fresh injection site. That doesn't look like blood. Alfred, I think I found the substance. Analyze and forward me the result.
Of course. I'll be in touch as soon as I have the results.
Where am I? Mr. Wayne? What's going on? Oh, but I got this awful feeling something terrible happened. Oh, everything is such a blur.
Sergeant, you have to think. What do you remember?
Oh, God. Falcone. I was hoping it wasn't real.
I believe you were drugged, Sergeant.
It would explain a lot. Listen, you have to believe me. I talk big about hurting thugs like Falcone, but I would never,
never betray the lieutenant. Everything is so foggy. I remember a sharp pain.
There's an injection site on your neck.
Then I just felt light. Like I could do whatever I wanted. No guilt, no consequence. There was a voice in my ear insisting Falcone was gonna get off. And all I knew was that I had to stop that. I had to, no matter what. The reasons why I shouldn't, they were a million miles away.
Did you see a face? Could you ID a suspect?
I don't think so.
You must remember some detail. Try.
I remember a hand on my arm, guiding me like a parent with a child. The voice, it was saying something about revolution.
Cobblepot said something similar.
I'm so sorry, Lieutenant. I've let you down.
We stalled Falcone's lawyers for now, but they'll be back. So how is she? Did she tell you anything?
Yeah, don't worry about that now.
I found evidence that she was drugged. A fresh injection site on her neck.
I was out of my mind, Lieutenant. Please believe me.
Hey, I do. Of course I do.
Hey, get forensics in here. Now!
She remembers a voice saying something about revolution.
That's not much to go on.
Now, if you're bringing forensics in, let's get Bruce out.
Alfred, I gotta get back to the manor. I've got a lead on whoever's behind this.
Bruce!
Hey, baby.
What are you doing here? My friends in the GCPD have been telling stories about some kind of lockdown?
I'm sorry, Vicky. I don't have time.
Don't brush me off. Word is there were shots fired near where Falcone was being held. Know anything about that? I mean, you must have been back there when it happened.
Always digging for a story, huh?
So it's true?
I didn't say that.
Listen, I owe you for those files on Falcone. I got a lot of credit at the Gazette for that story. Whatever's going on here, you can't afford to be associated with it. Let me help you. I can keep your name out of whatever we print, but you need to give me something I can use. Who fired the shots? A cop? I can tell by the way you're brushing me off that something happened. Just give me something to run with.
You're fishing. You don't have anything. Now if you'll excuse me.
You should talk to me, Bruce. This is coming out whether you stonewall me or not.
To be fair, I've done enough for you in your fucking career, to be honest with you, so...
Either Cobblepot drugged Montoya himself, or someone else is using his revolutionary rhetoric. Either way, I need to find him. Let's put our drones in the air and start a search. I'll run a trace on his cell. In the meantime, we have to find out what we can do about this drug.
The computer's been analyzing the chemicals from Montoya's bloodstream.
Throw that up on the monitor. The residue I scan on Montoya is similar to the nerve agent I found at Doc's. Let's see what we got.
It's ironic that Falcone died at the hands of someone drugged with his chemicals. Who'd have guessed that's how he'd meet his maker? Prone in his sick bed, surrounded by police who were ordered to protect him.
Falcone got off easy by getting killed. He deserved much worse.
Whoever did this was judge, jury, and executioner. No one should act as all three. I hope he told you something before he was killed. What did you learn from him?
Practically family, he said.
Family? Funny, I don't recall any Sunday dinners with the mob.
It wasn't Falcone who called the hit.
Yes, well, I suppose that makes sense. Your father, Hill, and Falcone would have balanced each other out.
Computers pinpointed reference points on the two compounds.
Oh.
The men at the docks were doused with the base chemicals. The reaction was messy. They were out of control. This refined drug is like a weapon. It only took a small injection to strip Montoya of her moral filters and make her act on her base impulses. Both compounds seem stable, but they're quick to fall apart. Whoever processed it knew what they were doing.
What could the creators of such a drug possibly have in mind?
I also love the fact that they're not protecting the characters. I think that's something that the Game of Thrones Telltale game got completely wrong in using Game of Thrones characters in their own story, because, you know, none of them are going to die, you know, nothing's going to happen to them, you know, because there are no alternate universes in Game of Thrones, it's sort of just one thing. So when you bring in TV characters, it just becomes fucking boring, you know, because you know they're not going to die. It strips all of the tension out of the scene. Whereas this, Falcone's fucking dead. I mean, wow, you know, that's huge.
Fighting your wars is one thing, but drugging others to fight them for you.
Oh. With this drug, they can exploit anyone's baser impulses, the things they would otherwise control.
Your drones are in position to triangulate Cobblepot's location.
Looks like he's becoming the Penguin more and more. That would be Arkham, wouldn't it?
There, don't you go. You'll be alright. You're right.
Falcone's body to get cold, did you, Oz?
Going to speak with him, Bruce?
Bruce Wayne already tried talking with Cobblepot. It's time he met the Batman.
Thank you.
Come check out this office. Where is he?
I don't know! Please!
Oh, names! Hey. You can help me.
Let him go.
Batman! It's about time! You kill a crime boss, you'd expect a word of thanks from Gotham's number one vigilante. But don't worry, I'll pass your gratitude on to those who made it happen.
You used an innocent cop to do your dirty work. I know how you've been using the drugs you stole at the docks. Where are they?
Is this about Falcone? We all saw how you felt about Falcone. Impaling a man on live TV. If you were truly the defender of this city, you'd have finished the job yourself. Admit it, Falcone deserved to die. Vermin like Falcone, they deserve to be stomped out. Believe me, I know.
Falcone had it coming, but that doesn't mean you're off the hook.
I like your choice of words. You know how to create an impression. As a show of good faith, I'm gonna let this one go. How's about we talk this through? We helped you with Falcone. Now, if we could just cut out the rest of the rot, like Wayne and Hill, ordinary folks might be able to breathe.
What is it about this place that attracts criminal scum like you? What does Bruce Wayne have to do with this?
Pretty Boy's got himself a fat bank account, thanks to his parents. Only problem is, they took that money from people that couldn't fight back. Here's the thing. I actually admire you, Batman. We both want the same kinds of things. Me and my people, we've got big plans for Gotham.
They found Catwoman.
What do you want with her?
We had a deal. She didn't make good on it. So sorry this didn't work out, mate. I'd stay to watch. I would, but I still got a Catwoman problem to deal with. Oh, what's her name again?
Selina.
Yes! Oh, beautiful name.
Guess we just kill this guy then.
Track down Selina Kyle.
I'll find her right away.
Johnny Crash.
Is that Bruce Wayne?
You really think he'd show up here?
Oh, tunes for drinking, dancing, and fighting. Not necessarily in that order.
Care? The cops raided his house. Sorry.
You lost? Because I don't have time for tourists. Looks like you walked into the wrong bar.
Yeah, I'm looking for a woman.
You wouldn't be the first.
Selena Kyle, I'm told she practically lives here.
Selena, huh? You don't strike me as her type.
You'd be surprised.
Hey, don't I know you? It is you. Knew it. Cops take all your fancy clothes? Are you trying to lay low? Of course, you're not really the low-lying type.
Buy you a drink?
How about a few? It ain't like you're short on cash.
Leave him alone, Frank. Man's just trying to have a quiet drink.
He didn't seem to mind the company. Whatever.
Seems all right.
Selena, I need to tell you something important.
Better be an apology. You were supposed to take care of our mutual problem. Instead, you just pissed him off.
Well, I've met a couple of his goons myself. Your client isn't one for subtlety. The man who hired you, his name is Oswald Cobblepot.
Never heard of him.
He goes by Penguin.
Penguin? Shit. Ugh, you've got to be kidding me. You should have just killed me on that rooftop. I'm dead anyway. When you screw someone over, you really screw them. The Penguin.
It's not my fault that you're in this, Selena, but I can help you out of it. Tell me what you know about Penguin.
I only know him by reputation. I'm surprised you never heard of him. He's a big deal across the pond. He's more dangerous than you think. You don't know what you're getting into.
I've seen his rap sheet. Just a string of petty crimes, nothing major.
So he's good at covering his tracks. No one gets to his level without knowing how to keep a low profile. Besides, you really think there's another guy going by Penguin? The question is, why Gotham? Why now? It's not like he's hurting for crime syndicates abroad. Why leave that?
Oswald wanted Falcone out of the picture. Looks like he succeeded.
So what? He wants to take his place?
Maybe. For starters.
Well, I'm not sticking around here to find out.
Oswald... Penguin is about to unleash God knows what on the city. You can't just leave.
A good reason not to be here when he does. You want to stay? That's your choice.
I need you, Selena.
That right?
If Penguin is as deadly as you say, I need all the help I can get.
Bruce, sweetie, the gallant knight thing, it really is adorable. But what would Harvey think? The two of us, working together. After all, I'm not really an all work and no play kind of girl. Harvey knows that.
I'm sorry, why are we talking about Harvey?
He's your friend, isn't he? Just seeing how much of a conscience you really have. You and I... Well, Bruce, you were right.
Selena Kyle, Penguin says hello.
That's the worst British accent ever. Like, just the worst.
Beat it. We're here for her. If you care about your own skin...
Thank you.
done yet.
Really? Why would you carry on fighting these people? Why would... No one would do this. They're just beating your ass with their bare fucking hands. Why would you do it?
I think they want more.
Let's give it to them.
Stay down, for fuck's sake. Why are you still fighting?
You fight pretty good for such a pretty boy. Come on, this way.
Are we alone?
Yeah, we're alone.
Why not? Yeah, I didn't.
Let's get out of here.
Gotta get Bruce.
I'll take the rooftops. You take the alley.
Wait. Just stay out of trouble.
Now, where's the fun in that? You shouldn't trust me, you know.
I know. I won't. Trying to get Bruce's jollies.
Alfred, I'm uploading the contents of a smartphone to the back computer. Check to see if there's anything on the phone we can use.
Processing it now. Is everything all right? There are quite a few police cars convening on your location.
It's fine. Has the back computer found anything yet?
Bruce, there are a number of messages here. All from Mayor Hill.
Mayor Hill?
The last voicemail is his. Listen to this.
I gave you everything I have on Wayne. I've held up my end of the bargain, and I expect you to do the same.
This is very shady indeed. Whatever they're talking about, it doesn't sound good.
I should have guessed. Hill's working with Penguin. If Hill's talking to Penguin, he must know something. It's time I paid him a visit.
I agree. The mayor must have answers, but if I may offer a word of advice... The whole world was horrified at what Batman did to Falcone. You terrorized the mayor too. You could lose Gotham's goodwill completely.
Fuck their goodwill.
Then again, Batman's methods would certainly get him talking immediately. Bruce would have to depend on his guile to loosen Hill's lips.
Yeah, I want to go as Batman, you know. And yeah, I agree, yeah. I mean, there's lots of British people out there that they could have fucking hired.
Going as Batman is the sure bet.
Better to be feared than loved. Better to be feared than loved. Thank you.
whole city is already afraid of the Batman after what you did to Falcone. Try not to make things worse by going overboard on Hill. Battering the mayor is not a good option, despite his more than checkered reputation.
I just want to scare him.
The city will thank me later if Hill tells me Penguin's plans.
No, they won't. That's the whole point of Batman. Everyone hates you, dude. But you do it anyway.
You incompetent! Dent up in the polls. I need to crucify him in the debate or we can kiss re-election and your job goodbye. You'd better be back here in the next 15 minutes or I'm cutting your... Who's there? Deborah? Deborah? Is that you?
Expecting someone? Maybe the Penguin?
Batman? What are you doing here?
You know who Penguin is.
So I've heard of him. So what? I've got nothing to do with that lowlife. Do you hear me?
You're leaving out a few details.
I gave you everything I have on Wayne. I've held up my end of the bargain, and I expect you to do the same.
Wayne, there's the real problem. He's the one you should be after. Every fiber of his being built on lies.
What does Penguin want with Bruce Wayne?
The atrocities that occurred at the hands of his father. He only wants to expose the Waynes for the criminals that they are. Security!
I will close the door on Batman. Pick
up, goddammit! Security!
Fucking have some of this.
Don't kill me! I've done nothing wrong!
I want the truth. And I'll break every bone in your body to get it.
You're insane. Just like they say. A madman in a mask. Penguin wants revenge for what happened to his mother. Thomas Wayne sent her to Arkham, along with who knows how many other innocents. Nothing was wrong with any of them.
Something this big couldn't have been hidden. There'd be records.
With enough money, you can make anything or anyone disappear. I didn't dare speak up. Whatever happened in the past, it's nothing compared to what's happening now. Penguin isn't the only child of Arkham. There are others whose families were destroyed by Wayne. They'll make Gotham pay for his sins. No. Please. Don't.
They'll have to go through me first.
If I had given Penguin what he wanted, he would have struck at the debate tonight. I didn't just do this for myself. I'm trying to protect Gotham. Finally. About damn time.
It's Batman! Shoot him! Come on, get the mayor out of here!
I heard everything, Master Bruce. What he said about your father, it must be difficult to process.
I need to know what went on in Arkham Asylum.
Indeed. I'm just as frustrated as you are.
Hill seems to think he's safe, but Penguin's still out there. What else is on here?
As per your request, Lieutenant Gordon has tripled security at the debate.
Thanks, Alfred.
But Gordon heard about Batman's surprise visit to the mayor. He was far from happy.
Thanks for the heads up.
It's a plan of the old Monarch Theater.
The auditorium where the debate's being held. I hacked into the image feeds from the security cameras at the auditorium.
Just to be safe.
Just to be safe.
Hills, details about your father. Am
must have been quite upsetting. I can't imagine how you must feel.
To hear their crimes detailed, first by Falcone, then by a snake like Hill, it makes me question myself.
You shouldn't, Bruce. You are your own man. And the city needs you, now more than ever. I'll leave you to it then.
Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent appears to be hitting some potholes on his path to the mayor's office. Despite the backing of billionaire Bruce Wayne, rumors persist that the candidate is having trouble paying his campaign staff and making ad buys. A Dent spokesperson said these rumors are nothing more than a smear tactic, perpetuated by the incumbent Mayor Hill's campaign.
In other news, nobody goes to Gotham's dive bars expecting a quiet night out, but police say a brawl tonight at the Stack Deck Bar in Otisburg was the rowdiest one in recent memory. Reports say multiple arrests were made, with all the suspects taken into custody while unconscious. Police are seeking an unidentified man and woman who were seen in conversation with the assailants shortly before the fight.
Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent appears to be hitting some potholes on his path to the mayor's office. Despite the backing of billionaire Bruce Wayne, rumors persist that the candidate is having trouble paying his campaign staff and making ad buys. A Dent spokesperson said these rumors are nothing more than a smear tactic, perpetuated by the incumbent Mayor Hill's campaign.
In other news, nobody goes to Gotham's dive bars expecting a quiet night out, but police say a brawl tonight at the Stack Deck Bar in Otisburg was the rowdiest one in recent memory. Reports say multiple arrests were made, with all the suspects taken into custody while unconscious. Police are seeking an unidentified man and woman who were seen in conversation with the assailants shortly before the fight.
Wait a minute. The images on these cameras haven't changed. Something's wrong.
Penguin's men may have commandeered the cameras on their end. We could just be looking at
what they want us to see. Warn Gordon that he may have visitors. I have to get down there. Now.
All right.
Harvey needs to get out of there.
And Lucius Fox.
Hey, Bruce. Man, I'm glad you called. I needed to talk to you, actually. Something's come up. Something that's... well, it's not exactly pleasant.
Harvey, listen to me. Your life is in danger.
There's a Penguin and his thugs?
Thanks, but there is an army of security here. They have me in some back room until the debate begins.
For my own protection, they said. A little bit of overkill, if you ask me.
It's not overkill, Harvey. It's a real...
Please. I need to
get this off my chest.
Look.
Bruce, I didn't want to do this over the phone, but...
My advisors are telling me that I need to...
that I need to...
distance myself from you. Until all this mess with your family blows over.
I don't care, Harvey. You need to get out of there.
I can't leave now.
I mean, think of the message that would send to the voters. Bruce, I'm ahead in the polls. A win tonight, and I could take the election. And what with the allegations in the press, and now this mess with Falcone, you're
a liability.
But here's the thing, Bruce.
Without your money...
I am dead in the water. I know this is a delicate topic, but I need you to keep me afloat.
I may have to trash you in public, but you and me, we'll know the truth about our friendship.
No matter what, we need a new mayor. Hill needs to be removed.
I
knew you'd see it that way.
Listen, I hate to push you,
but I need to know. Can I count on your money, Bruce?
Whatever it takes to save Gotham, that's what we wanted.
I'll always support you, Harvey.
Oh, thank you, Bruce. Thank you. You don't know how much this means to me. To Gotham. I'm sorry, Bruce. The makeup person is here. Guess she needs to put on my face.
I hope you can still watch the debate somewhere. No matter what I have to say tonight, remember.
You are always my friend.
Harvey!
Breaking the fourth wall a bit too much now. I mean, you know. Yes, we know he's Two-Face. We know he's Two-Face. Okay, you can stop winking at me now.
Batman!
Yeah, all quiet so far.
I've got a feeling that's about to change.
I just had the mayor in my ear about your visit. And after what you did to Falcone...
Listen. I value you looking out for the city, really.
People are terrified of you, including my cops.
Fine by me. Just give me the report so I can protect the debate.
Fine. Just do it without splitting anyone in half, huh? The GCPD has orders to take you in. After tonight, I can't stand in their way anymore.
We have bigger things to worry about right now. Your security has been compromised.
I've got patrols on every door.
You better check on them.
I'd keep that holstered if I were you.
What's she doing here? She was part of that robbery at the mayor's office.
Really? You're gonna drag out that dead horse?
We're all on the same side, Jim.
This better not come back to bite me. Alpha Patrol, come in.
That, incident in the bar. Dead is its own kind of cage. I can't stand being in it. Not that I needed your help or anything, but you had my back. I thought I'd repay the favor. You know, like you scratch my back, I cut some people up.
You don't owe me anything. Those scum had it coming.
And they say chivalry is dead.
None of my men on the ground are responding.
Enough waiting. We're going in.
Alpha, do you read?
Now aren't you glad I'm here?
I'm not being nice to you. I just don't want any fucking, you know. You don't owe me anything, it's fine. Fuck you. Just... Because I know if I try and put her in debt...
You've got a shot to my SWAT team of getting in there quietly.
I know if I put her in debt, Jimmy, she's just gonna...
Sounds like a vote for Dent, Lieutenant.
Like, you know, if I try and tie her down with things like she'll just...
...for a live debate for the next mayor of Gotham City. This is an important debate for these two candidates, incumbent Mayor Hamilton Hill and the challenger, Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent. And it's also important for you, the citizens of Gotham.
You know, she'd rebel against that and probably betray me, so I just said, yeah, you don't know me if the damn things, you know, whatever. Let her go her own way, let her do her own thing. Give her a long leash.
At least we know why they weren't responding.
Gordon, we found one of your patrols. They've been terminated.
As you might have guessed, there's been a change to tonight's program. First order of business, firing the moderator!
I hate to be a downer, but these hostages, I don't like their chances.
He just didn't have a head for the issues.
Casualties are inevitable. It's only a question of how many.
Inspiring. You really know how to pep a girl up.
You'll do. Get out here. Keep it quiet back there.
These guys are armed to the teeth.
We need a new moderator.
Come on, you.
You there. Yes. You. Thank you for volunteering.
Please. No.
Go on, then. Introduce the candidates. Stage fright, huh? All right, I'll get you started. But this is your show.
Three hostiles. Gotta take them out quietly.
Well, that looks good.
Maybe next time.
What?
Keep your heads down. Make for the police line.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
My gallant brothers and sisters of Gotham, you have nothing to fear. We are the children of Arkham. We are here to end the masquerade and expose the corruption that ruined your city. For too long, men like your esteemed mayor have profited from the pain of innocence.
They knew this was too big for Oswald alone. Someone else is pulling the strings.
Smart. Let someone else do the dirty work.
Look into the hearts of these spineless creatures. Chosen to
go on, love. You know what to do.
Saw that moderator get shot on live TV. What's going on in there?
First off, we should incinerate the pool. Roll the tape!
Subject 9.
Dad.
I thought your father was dead.
Subject 9. Esther Cobblepot. You've been declared criminally insane and committed to Arkham indefinitely as a ward of the state.
Please, I'll sell you the land. Please don't do this.
You had your chance. You should have made the deal we offered you. Give her the drug.
Thomas, we're friends. Our boys play together.
You were warned, Esther. You know I always get what I want. Commence the procedure. Give her a dose she won't come back from.
Now you know. Now you will see.
Certainly know how to make an entrance.
Go!
Why don't you kick the crap out of here?
Son of a bitch.
Please, I made him end
up. You cool,
never. That's all. Sway, not me. I took out Thomas Wayne. That was all him. He didn't know when to stop. I had him killed because of it.
That won't bring back my poor old mum. So this is for her.
You won't let you kill anyone else!
Wait your turn, Dent!
I got it! I pressed the fucking button. Don't be fucking silly, game.
Batman!
Don't be fucking silly. We'll do all this again now. Fucking pathetic.
Go!
I must have pressed like 5 times.
Why don't you kick the crap out of him?
No! Please! I made him end up!
You could never!
That is all! Sway! Help me! I took him! I took out Thomas Wayne! That was all him! He didn't know when to stop! I had him killed because of it!
That won't bring back my poor old mum. So this is for her.
You won't let you kill anyone else!
Wait your turn, Dent! Your maid, Bruce Wayne, your biggest supporter, and he didn't even turn up. Batman! The revolution's already started! It's too late to join!
I'm not here to join you. I'm here to crush you.
That's what I was afraid of.
No!
Uh-oh. I think I've got to go get Selena, because she's literally going to get fucking annihilated. And now he's Two-Face. And he doesn't know I'm Batman, so
hold your fire, it's fine. Damn it.
Harvey.
Where's the maniac in the mask? We need paramedics over here, now!
City Hall is in chaos after Mayor Hamilton Hill was confirmed dead.
While several members of the Children of Arkham have been arrested, the Penguin is still at large.
He won't be the same after this.
Meanwhile, the Wayne family scandal continued to escalate after the full list of Thomas Wayne's victims was released to the public. Representing Bruce Wayne have no comment at this time.
We are the Children of Arkham, and we have opened your eyes.
So we didn't actually get to make very many decisions in that one, did we? Did you ease Falcone's pain or make him suffer? Not really a choice, because he died straight after that. But, you know. But, you know, me and a lot of other people eased his pain, which is cool. 65%. Did you kiss Selina? Yeah, nearly 80% of people kissed Selina. Okay, cool. To be fair, Bruce has had it really bad. So I figured, you know, he needed some loving. Plus, I don't think there's any part of Batman where those two actually get together, so I think it'd be pretty cool if we can make that happen. That'd be a first, wouldn't it? Then I mean actually together, not just like a kiss or a fling or something. That'd be quite funny if I could actually make them get together. Did you visit Mayor Hill as Bruce or Batman? Me and 53.1% visited him as Batman. Okay. Did you withdraw your funding for Harvey's campaign? You are 90.6% continued to fund Harvey's campaign. Okay. Okay. I think the main guy is Scarecrow. Main bad guy. Because he has the gases and the drugs and stuff. He was in Batman Begins, if I remember correctly. Scarecrow. Did you save Selina or Harvey? You and 63.3% saved Selina. I saved Selina because, you know, Harvey abandoned Bruce, basically. And Selina, like, actually stuck her neck out for him there. And I was like, okay, fair enough. And she was going to be shot, as in, like, actually shot dead. You know, so. So, I knew Harvey's injuries would be severe, but I don't think he was going to be killed by that thing. Okay. So unlike last time, nearly all of my decisions were erring on the side of, you know, most people did the choices that I made. Or like last time when there was two or three of them where I literally, you know, made decisions that were way against what everyone else made. But this time, yeah. Yeah, so I think it's Scarecrow. I think it's a really good choice of villains, actually, Scarecrow and Penguin. I like the way Penguin's written. I like the way everyone's written in this. This is absolutely fantastic. This has been really, really good. First two episodes, I've been so, so impressed with the way that they've handled Batman. And this just shows you, when you're brave, and when you trust in yourselves, you trust the fact that you're Telltale and you can actually write a story and do, you know, and make people feel things, this is what happens. When you're brave and you actually kill people off, and you actually, you know, make the story your own, things are fucking awesome. So remember that. And next time you do a Game of Thrones, if you do one, do it fucking properly. And stop boring the shit out of me with choices that don't matter. Okay? Good. Right. So. This was really, really, really good. Really fantastic. Really impressed. And if you want more, then you know what to do. Subscribe to the channel, follow the channel, and subscribe to Traveling 7 on YouTube. Though I will be going through every single part of this because I'm really enjoying it, and now we've got loads of time to wait for the next one as well, which is why I was saying before, like, I like to binge on these things. Normally I wait until a Telltale game's completely out before I actually buy it, but I say my girlfriend bought this one for me, so I'm gonna have to go through it bit by bit as they come out, which is gonna be excruciating, but meh, it's fine. Memory of Mark Neal. Oh, that's a shame. Wonder who that was. Oh. Wonder if we get a trailer.
Next time on Batman, the Telltale series.
You may have saved me, but this isn't over. You don't know these people, Bruce.
Authorities are scrambling. The so-called Children of Arkham have the city in a frenzy, but there's still no sign of their masked leader. With Hill and Falcone dead by their hands, the question on everyone's lips is, who's next?
After that news about your father sending innocent people to Arkham, sounds like the whole city wants your head on a pike.
The Waynes have always run this company, but now they want to decide what your future at this company will be.
Do you really think Bruce Wayne is worth protecting?
What do you want from me?
You know what I want.
No more hiding! Not for anyone.
But don't worry. Bruce Wayne's finally gonna get what's coming to him. Bruce! Bruce!
Okay, so thanks for watching, and I'll speak to you guys a little bit later on.